What's going on, YouTube? This is Necrostevo, and now it is time to build a team for the Battle of Hoenn Wi-Fi competition. Now, it is the 22nd or Thursday. The competition starts tomorrow. Let's build a team that really takes into account a lot of the threats that I spoke of, or at least we're going to try to get as many of them as we can while still having fun. I think whenever team building, it's important to start with the focal point. For me this time, I'm going to start with what Mega Pokemon I want to build the team around. And after testing a lot, I'm going to build it around Mega Glalie. My specific Mega Glalie, I think, is going to go ahead and be max attack, max speed. I'm not going to mess around with Refrigerate this time, just because I'm not going to be dealing with Rotom Wash and other things that I would be hitting with Refrigerate. And I don't really want to use Glalie's weaker special attack move pool in order to try to hit things, when the really only reason to use that is for freeze dry, and I don't really want to be bothered with that. So we're going to be going with Jolly here alongside max attack. I guess I can throw that last 4 EV, so 301, or I guess he'd actually have we'll have 4 there. Alrighty, now as far as the moveset goes, I think I'm going to go ahead and run Protect so that I can get the free Mega Evolution alongside Ice Shard, which is basically the number one reason to run it. It just allows me to hit all the dragons pretty hard. Mega Glalie also has the bulk to live any one hit from them, so also I can take a hit and then retaliate back. Then outside of that, I don't want to run Explosion, that way if there's just something that I can't deal with after I scout to see whether or not I can hit it, then I can just blow up on it. Alternatively, I could just run Return. I don't necessarily want to run, I could run Iron Head, but there's only a couple of fairies, and generally using Return would be stronger than Iron Head, even if it's super effective. You know, running all ice moves is a weird idea. But I can definitely see Return working. But do I want to run all ice moves is the question. Because I'm going to have to breed this one tonight, because I actually haven't trained at Glalie yet. But I had some fun with it on the simulator earlier, so why not? You know, we're going to come back to that. For now, this is going to be the Glalie that we build around. Now, as far as I want to choose one other Mega, and then we can start trying to support them. And I already know for that Mega, I want to use Sableye, just because it pairs so well with Glalie, with Glalie being weak to those fighting type attacks. We're gonna see a lot of priority Breloom. As a matter of fact, Mach Punch is probably going to be really, really popular. I might even use a Breloom myself. So we're just gonna bring Sableye so we can get around that. I think that we're gonna actually go for the good old we're just gonna go for max defense, max HP with the bold set. That way I can burn things. I'm gonna go ahead and give them 4 more in special attack there, and I'm gonna do plus defense. Oops, that's an equal sign. Not as useful to put an equal sign there, and minus attack, we'll say. That way, before I get my magic bounce ability, if I mega evolve, then I can have access to magic bounce, which will help me out against some things. But if I wait, I can use Prankster to utilize Will-O-Wisp. I can utilize Recover, of course. And since this is the Mega Sableye that I'm using, we'll want to do Calm Mind and Dark Pulse. This will enable me to set up on some things if I have the opportunity to. Otherwise, I can see whether or not I even need to bother Mega Evolving. And I can just bring Sableye and then burn some things, basically. And then I can, of course, stall some things out with Recover as well. So that'll be kind of useful there. So Glalie and Sableye. Now let's see here. Let's just go through the list here. We know that right now we're kind of pseudo-threatened by several things. Fortunately, between Glalie and Sableye, I kind of deal with a lot of the big threats that I ended up mentioning previously. I don't have to worry about too many dragons because I have Ice Shard potential here. And even if they do take out Glalie, I can use a Prankster type Will-O-Wisp. I'm not worried about Breloom. I am worried about Mega Alakazam right now. Mega Alakazam can use Dazzling Gleam. Or not Mega Alakazam, I'm just worried about regular Alakazam. Because it can use Dazzling Gleam to hit Sableye, and it can use Focus Splash to hit Glalie. So, I need something to deal with that. Well, another type of priority would be nice, because I can outspeed Alakazam and hit it with the priority Ice Shard, which would be useful. But, outside of that, I don't know... I don't think he's going to be doing too much to Mega Sableye with a plus one Calm Mind. Because if I saw an Alakazam, I would immediately go ahead and Mega Evolve to get the defensive boost. And then I would still have Prankster to get off my Calm Mind before he hit me. So, I'm actually curious really quick here, just to see how strong that is. So we're just going to go Sableye, Mega Sableye. Or no, actually, we need to swap these Pokemon. But that's okay, I'll do that in a second. Alakazam. We're going to swap them. We're going to go for the special attacking set. Special attack. It's probably going to be timid if we run into it, so that won't affect the special attack. Let's just see how much a Dazzling Gleam does to a Sableye that has... I'm going to do the physical wall. And he's a bold nature. We'll say plus one to a special defense here. And we'll say worst case scenario that he's holding a life orb. That way, I really do think that if I see one, they will have Focus Sash. But you know, just in case. Wait, there's no. Here we go. Held item. L is for life orb. Or it's for Landside Berry. Pokemon ABCs, everyone. Alrighty, so let's go ahead and calculate that. Oh yeah, he still has a chance of 2-hit KOing. That sucks. So yeah, so I need a secondary way to deal with Alakazam right now, as I feel like I have Breloom taken care of, and so will the dragons. I could just do more priority, or I could do Sucker Punch, would actually probably handle Alakazam quite handily. Sucker Punch. Sucker Punch users in the Hoenn decks are going to be Absol. I don't think Mighty Yena gets Sucker Punch. I know he gets... Does he get Sucker Punch? Let's take a quick look-see. This is the nice part about team building online, because you can just go in really fast and just see. He does get Sucker Punch. Alright, cool. That's why I didn't think so. He gets it a lot later than I had mine in the game. Alrighty. So I could use a Mighty Yena. I don't think I want to use a Mighty Yena, but I could. So Mighty Yena, Absol, Cacturn. Who else gets Sucker Punch? I think that's going to be it. There aren't that many Dark types in this region either. The only other dark type is Sharpedo. If I don't want to use a Sucker Punch that's not Stab either. So Absol is looking really good for Sucker Punch uses actually, and that would also give me a secondary way to counter Latias and Latios. Not Mega Absol though. I don't really want to. Cacturn would be good because then I would get the Grass typing, allowing me to switch in on things like Spore. And also Cacturn gets Water Absorb. So that's actually sounding pretty good as well. Let's go ahead and... I'm going to put Cacturn here for now. Well, I spelled that wrong. Let's try that again. There we go, Cacturn. With that wonderful Water Absorb ability. Probably will run a Lumberry on Cacturn, though. And we're running him mainly for Sucker Punch. Alongside Seed Bomb. There we go, we have... two additional types there. And so now we have Ice, we have Dark, we have, well, I have two Dark moves now, but now we have Grass. So Cacturn, of course, is weak to Bug, Ice, Flying, Fire, Fighting, and we can hit. We're not worried about Bug with these two, really, because we don't have to worry about Caesar here. The only Bugs worried about are Mega Pinsir, which could be a problem, but Mega Pinsir does not want to take an ice type attack. Even if he does, I'll speed Glalie. I can hit him really hard with one, because he can't one hit KO me with a quick attack. I can also burn him with Sableye. We're also worried about... I'm not running Substitute, so I don't have to worry about Mega Heracross coming in with any Skilling shenanigans. What else are we worried about with Bug? Flying, you're really only going to see something like Swellow, I think. You may also see Skarmory, just because it's so wonderfully defensive. Oh, Crobat, of course. So right now, Crobat kind of is annoying, because it can taunt Sableye. It can hit Megaglalie relatively hard with a Brave Bird before I even get to hit it. And of course, Nightshark won't take it out. And it can Brave Bird Cacturne. So actually, I'm going to go ahead and give Cacturne Spiky Shield, because that will allow me to force those things to attack, and then I can hit them with a Sucker Punch to Thrive Whittle them down with a Spiky Shield. I don't really know what to put in the last slot. Maybe Destiny Bond, I know he gets that. Encore would be interesting, but I actually don't think I can breathe that onto him. Teeter Dance would be hilarious, but I don't like relying on things like that. Not so much hilarious as infuriating to fight against, actually. I don't know what you guys think about Confusion Shenanigans. I don't really like relying on them. I much rather we use something like Flash or something like that to lower my opponent's accuracy like I used back in VGC days. Flash is just so annoying because it's like, no matter what you do, you might miss. Whereas with Confusion, you have a 50-50 shot. But let's see. You know, let's just go ahead and go Destiny Bond. Just in case. Of course, if you do use Destiny Bond and you use it and then your opponent takes you out and that's both of your last Pokemon, you will get the victory there. So, why not? Of course, with Cacturne, you want to go max attack. And you don't need that much speed. You actually only need a little bit of speed. I think you need 94 to outspeed something like Milotic. Or 96, rather. 94 is not divisible by 4. I don't know why I said that. With the rest in HP. Yeah. And then definitely Adamant, we want to make sure we're hitting as hard as possible with that Sucker Punch. And I just want to make sure that a Sucker Punch has the capability to take out something like a Latias, since that's a little bit more bulky. So we're going to go Cacturne. Why doesn't Cacturne have a Mega Evolution, darn it? I think I was talking to Guy the other day on Twitter, and he was theory mining. He said, what if Mega Cacturne got Prankster? And that would just be just so very, very nice, I have to say. That would be pretty amazing. I'm all for grass types getting more buffs like that, I guess, at the end of the day. So, alrighty, so we're Sucker Punch. Where are you? You should be near the end. In the end, oh yeah. There we go, finally. Get some speedy tech scroll going on there. We're gonna say mixed wall, I guess. I don't know. That's not what. No. Latias doesn't write anything like that. Say it has 128 HP investment, and we'll say. I don't know. I'm just gonna put a number here. In case someone just wants a really freaking bulky Latias. I really doubt someone's going to go through the trouble like I did and make a mega Latias that is really annoying. It can live a lot of things. So. So Cacturne, Sucker Punch is a guaranteed 2-hit KO before or after leftovers, rather. So I could. So if I gave it a Life Orb, that would make sure it always KOs it, even when it has defensive investment, basically, right? Right? That's what I'm reading from that, right? Or wait, what if I give it Black Glasses? Would that be enough? A 20% increase in power? Would that be a guaranteed KO? Let's try that out. Because I don't think I'll be using Seed Bomb that often. No, it's still not guaranteed. So Life Orb would make it guaranteed. So Black Glasses actually sounds nice. Because if I can get some previous damage on it with something else, with another form of priority, then I could do it almost every time with Sucker Punch. But Life Orb should be a guaranteed KO, even if there's a defensive investment. Yeah. I don't think it'll have leftovers either. It'll probably have Soul Dew. So, yeah, we're just going to go with Black Glasses on Cacturne instead of Lumberry. Hopefully, I can predict any possible burn attempts, because I don't really want to deal with that. So now we have. See, now whenever I add a grass type to a team, I'm really tempted to do a grass, water, fire core. It just takes hits so well. But that's not as useful with the Hoenn decks, of course, because there's only a few fire types. You basically get Blaziken, Camerupt, I don't know who else we're talking about here. Ninetales I know is in there. You get Makargo, you get Torkoal. There's Knight. That's it. So I'm not really as worried about fire. It is very tempting to use Blaziken just to have access to speed boost. I actually just bred a really nice one in case I decided to use it in this tournament. But, let's see. Blaziken will give me fire and fighting type coverage. And I would not run anything like Makargo or Camerupt unless I was using Camerupt's Mega and running Trick Room or something like that. So they're not really in this mix here. Although a Psychic fighting Dark Core is pretty nice as well, because then I could use Alakazam and then also use Blaziken. That's not bad either. Right now we're sitting one. We have two physical attackers and one special attacker. So let's go ahead and I'm going to try that. I've never actually used a Blaziken. But if I use one, it would definitely be Life Orbed. Because as I mentioned in that video, I don't really think you want to deal with having it be a Mega, your Mega Pokemon. Even though the attack increase is pretty significant. So we're just going to use Protect here so we can get a free speed boost. High Jump Kick, because I love missing those darn moves there. Wait, I don't understand. No. Where is that? I don't see High Jump Kick. Where are you? There you are. Oh, they actually spelled it out now. I'm still thinking of the spelling of High Jump Kick, or it was H-I, because they had a letter limit. It's the same reason they had for Alligator, with its name ending in TR instead of TER. It's just like, oh, you just have this arbitrary letter limit because of the amount of memory you're working with. But that's okay. Flare Blitz as well. And I'll probably take a look at some other options here in a second. But last but not least, I want a rock type move. I don't have any rock moves so far. Not that I'm very worried about flying types with Glalie. But right now, something like a Salamence Walls Blaziken, which is not a great place to put yourself in. Do I get Stone Edge? Oh, I get Stone Edge. I know he gets Rock Slide. I think I'm going to take... Let's see here. So, with Blaziken... that's Blast Voice. There you are, Blaziken. Alright, so with Blaziken, we got him with a Life Orb. Good old Life Orb. Jolly... And we have the physical attacker. And with that, we're going to be using... I'm going to see just how... I think the strongest thing that I'm going to be hitting with a Rock Slide is Mega Salamence. Oops, I don't know why I did that. There we go, Mega Salamence. And I don't think we'd see a defensive Mega Salamence. But just if someone were to invest a little bit in his HP, for example... How much damage are we talking about here? That is the question. I just realized I've been doing calculations this whole time at level 100. Not as accurate. I'm doing a little bit more damage there at level 50. So, ooh, 3 hit KO. Good grief. Okay, what if I use Stone Edge? Wait, is that a... Yeah, good. Man, that is so weak. Alrighty then. I never thought I'd say that. So let's try Stone Edge over Rock Slide. Stone Edge will always 2 hit KO. Which doesn't matter as much because Salamence will one hit KO with everything he uses with being the whole aerial boost thing. Although I could protect and get my speed boost and then I'd be faster than him, so I'd have a flinch chance with Rock Slide. So I really do like that better. I tend to miss Stone Edge a lot too. Is there anything on this list that I'm hitting besides that? Because I would Flare Blitz something like Skarmory. I would still try to High Jump Kick a Swallow or something like that. The other dragons are Altaria and Flygon. I would not be Stone Edging Flygon. I would not be High Jump Kicking Altaria, so yeah, I'd use a Stone Edge there too. And then... Man, I can't believe I'm making the case for Stone Edge for once. Pinsir and Heracross. Yeah. I think I'm just going to keep it with Rock Slide, because then if I have the chance to flinch, I might have the higher chance of hitting. Because I can't KO it either way. So I'd rather rely on the 30% chance of flinching over the higher critical hit ratio. Because it basically doubles the critical hit ratio, which puts you at about 14. So if we're playing a percentage game, Rock Slide makes more sense. And so since I'm trying to do the fighting psychic and dark core, we're going to go ahead and do Alakazam. I'm going to go ahead and make him the Sash variant just because it's nice to have that insurance. I feel like if I see an Alakazam, I will most likely be dealing with the Sash variant. You might see Life Orb on some of them. But yeah, let's just go with Psy Shocker Psychic. I'm gonna go with Psychic just because, yeah, I can make that argument, I guess. I don't know. Psychic because it's stronger there, that's why. Or actually, looking at the Pokemon that are in Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, I wonder if they skew more physically defensive or specially defensive. I'm just curious what that overall determination is. Let's see. One. That's more defensive. That's more specially defensive. That's more specially defensive. More physically defensive. It would be funny if it was really even. That's also specially defensive. That's also physically defensive. Physically. Just a bunch of HP there on Wailord. Yeah. More physical. More special. More physical. More physical. More special. Physical. Physical. Special. Physical. I could do this all day, folks. This is how they counted the vote tallies in Florida. You know, I think I'm seeing more of a physical split here. Just a quick glance over here. I don't know if I have a way to deal with Metagross yet either. I need to go back and look at that. Actually, I do, because I can burn him. And also, he can't do anything with me with Cacturne, because I can just Spiky Shield his face. So yeah, we're going to keep Psychic on there for now. Definitely want to use Dazzling Gleam and Shadow Ball. That'll give me a secondary way to hit Metagross. Dazzling Gleam allows me to hit Breloom and any of the other dragons. Also, it's just great coverage because now I don't have to rely on Focus Blast, because I hate relying on Focus Blast. And what would I put in that last slot, though? What would I put on the one that I burned already? Oh, I put Energy Ball. Well, I don't need Energy Ball with Cacturne. So instead of Energy Ball... Maybe... Light Screen or Reflect might be interesting, allowing one of my other Pokemon to do something. Wow, if you guys can hear that, that is my stomach. I don't know why it's making so much noise. I did eat yesterday. It should not be making that much noise. I'm not living in a developing country. I'm not that hungry. So stomach, please. Keep your inputs on this battle video, on this team building video, to a minimum. I would appreciate it. Does Alakazam get Taunt? I don't know if he does. He does not. I didn't think so. It would help if I spelled it correctly. Oh, he does get Taunt. That might be pretty interesting, actually. Psychic, Dazzling Gleam, and Shadow Ball. That stops me from hitting what, exactly? Because if they bring a Water-type Pokemon, Cacturne shuts down most of those. And if they bring a Water-type Pokemon that can use Ice-type moves, then I can just bring in... Or if they bring a Water-type Pokemon that can use Ice-type moves... Glalie doesn't care about the ice type move, so that's a free switch in, basically. I'm really tempted to use Taunt here. Because I'm faster than something like a Breloom. So if I think it's a Sash Breloom, I could just Taunt it. Although that doesn't make a lot of sense. If you see a Breloom, you should just shoot attacks at it because you don't want it setting up. Also, it could Rock Tomb you, making you slower than it. So, no. That doesn't make a lot of sense. 120... I don't know what to put in that last slot. Taunt seems really nice. Let's see, I have two dark types. I don't like that, honestly. In the last slot, based on a couple of shoutouts to Eric or Eshamus on Twitter, I had a couple of practice matches against him and against Guy, and I know for a fact that I want to use Latios with Soul Dude. Just because it's incredibly powerful, and with the Soul Dew, it's just so bulky. There's a reason why it's always banned from just about everything. And I caught a really good one, actually, from the other day. Because, of course, all the Pokemon you use in this have to be caught or bred in XY or Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. So, just the Draco Meteor goodness here. Just because. And then, now's my chance to use Psy Shock. There we go. And what else did I hunt on that? Actually, he gets a pretty nice move pool. I don't have any electric moves so far. I mean, I can give him Thunderbolt. As I already have... See, I feel like I'm so deathly afraid of, Mega Metagross, which I feel like everyone is going to be clustering around Mega Metagross, Mega Salamence, and possibly, something like Mega Gallade. I'm not really, this team doesn't really care about Mega Gallade between Sableye and Alakazam, but Mega Metagross might still be a problem. I can burn it, but they could be running Facade, they can be running special moves, so I really want to put another Shadow Ball here. That seems super redundant. I'm gonna have to come back and think about that. And I actually got a lot of use out of Memento, where it sacrifices the user, but then it lowers the opponent's attack and special attack by 2 stages. Especially since Latios is faster, if he has lower HP after taking a hit, then I can use Memento, then bring something else in and have it much more easily deal with the situation instead of having to take a really powerful hit. Now let's see here. I don't like the fact that this team has 2 dark types, and right now it also has 2 psychic types. Not great there. If I want to do, I can replace one of these Pokemon and get that Grass Water Fire Core and also a Dark Psychic Fighting Core. I really like that idea. And I'm keeping these two for sure because I want to use those 2 Megas. So that means Cacturne needs to switch to something. So let's switch Cacturne to... What am I missing? I'm missing water. No, if I take out Cacturne, then I don't have grass. Ah! This plagues me so. Okay, hold on. What about... Okay, I keep talking about how Breloom is such a huge threat. What about if I bring a Breloom? Specifically, a Technician Breloom. Utilizing... I'm gonna do it like this. We're gonna do Spore. We're gonna do... Bullet Seed for anyone trying to use Substitute Shenanigans. Mach Punch. And... Spore, Bullet Seed, Mach Punch. Probably Rock Tomb, just because Technician boosts are fun. Fast Physical Sweeper. Notice that Breloom's speed is only at 70. He's actually pretty slow. So even Glalie in its base form, base 80 speed, outspeeds Breloom. So I will be able to outspeed and hit in the face with a Ice Shard. But since now I have my grass and fighting Pokemon here, then I can switch Cacturne to something that's water based. That way I can switch in on water type moves and resist them. Probably Azumarill, actually. Then I can use good old huge power Azumarill. Give it an assault vest, because why not make it more bulky than it already is? Let's see. He's definitely going to have Aqua Jet. And also play Rough. And I don't like messing around with Belly Drum Shenanigans. Especially when you're dealing with a 3v3 scenario. It's not quite as reliable there. And plus, I feel like people will be running a lot of priority. So, between Belly Drum, Aqua Jet, and he also gets Waterfall, I could run Super Power. I could give him Facade just to play around burns. Water Normal is still really good coverage. Let's see. In this tier, Water Fairy hits everything, but it would have to be, what, a Steel. There's no Steel Grass types in this tier because Ferrothorn's in a different dex. There's no steel water types because Empoleon is in another deck, so I don't have to worry about that. Fairy is also resisted by poison. So a poison up Tentacruel. I wouldn't be able to hit Tentacruel. That would be annoying. So actually, yes, we're going to put Facade on here just to be able to deal with Tentacruel that likely will be running Scald, which might burn although he might just hit me with a poison type attack. But I don't see Tentacruel one-hit KOing me, so maybe he might poison me. Too bad Azumarill doesn't get Earthquake. That would be nice. What else am I worried about now? I could use Knock Off. That would be a good move, just the tech in there. Play Rough. Yeah, I think Knock Off is a good general, because this team is not worried about steel types at all. Because I can... The only steel types in the tier that I'm really worried about is Mega Mawile. I can burn that, and it's slower than... I don't have any fire type attacks to deal with Mega Mawile. I could bring something with Earthquake. I could give Glalie Earthquake instead of having all these ice moves. Protect, Ice Shard, Explosion, Return. Yeah, I could just give him Earthquake instead of Protect. Then I'd have a way to hit something like a Mega Mawile. Because Mawile is slow, which is nice. If he were fast with that attack, that's too much, Game Freak. Let's see. Earthquake there. I really like that. I don't feel like I'm going to mess with that at all. And in this last slot... I really like the idea of Knock Off. I still don't have a Sucker Puncher on my team, which I really wanted to put in there somewhere. Absol is quite cool, so that's not a terrible idea. But I already have my Dark type, so why would I have both? Wow, he can be Bread, Perish, Song. That's interesting. I wonder if he can do that in this generation, though. That's the question. We're going to put Knock Off here for now. And... Yep. The good old usual set. So a bulky sweeper there. Let's see. I feel like this is actually... So let's just go back through and look at the types of threats that I said I would be dealing with. And I have those on this handy dandy note here. So I'm going to pull up the team. And I'll slide this over here so you guys can see it too. Alrighty. So... Salamence and the Latis are dealt with quite handily between Mega Glalie. I have Shadow Ball on both of these Pokemon, which can hit Metagross and the Latis, although I can also have Dazzling Gleam for them. I don't care about Swampert with Ice Shard. Also, I have Assault Vest, so I can probably take one hit with Azumarill if I really had to. I can also Mach Punch all these Pokemon. Blaziken can't do much against Mega Sableye. Granted, I can't do much back to Blaziken, and his Flare Blitz will kill me eventually. But I can kill him with Latios, unless he's running. I resist both the High Jump Kick and the Fire Move with Latios, so I'm not worried about that. Altaria, I don't have any Poison-type moves. I do have Ice-type moves with Glalie, and I don't have any Steel-type moves either. I feel like that's an oversight of some sort. Sharpedo, I'm not worried about because I have Breloom. Camerupt, I'm not worried about because I have Latios, and I also have Assault Vest Azumarill. I'm not worried about other people's Sableye. I don't really have room for that moveset for Taunt, though. Taunt on here takes care of that, but then he'd probably... Oh, I have a Focus Sash, though. So, yeah, that's not too bad. Manectric. Can't really touch Latios without Hidden Power Ice, and even then that wouldn't do that much. Thank goodness for Soul Dew. That's the only way I can really deal with Manectric. Gyarados, Breloom. I like just being able to say one more counters for things. Gallade, Sableye, and Latios. It might have Shadow Sneak. I also have the Sash on Alakazam as the last deal there. Glalie, I can Mach Punch. I also have Azumarill with Aqua Jet. I can also Burn it, although I don't think Burn will help much if he's using an Ice-type Explosion. That would suck. Mawile, I have Earthquake here, I can burn it, and I have faster priority in the form of Azumarill. I don't think I'm going to run into Heracross, but if I do, I can just use Latios, which I can outspeed him with a second type attack. I really want to use my own Absol, darn it. If I see Absol though, I could definitely just Mach Punch it in the face. I don't think I can kill it with one, but between Mach Punch and a Ice Shard, that should be enough to finish him off. Scarf Medicham would be really annoying. Uh, hmm. Well, if he locks himself in a high jump kick, then he's easy to deal with. But other than that, let's see. Any smash and pash teams? Smash and pash. Smash, 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 smash. Okay. Smash. Pass. There we go. We finally got it. Thank you all for your support in this endeavor of smash and pass. Smash and pass. Gorbis and Huntail. Gorbis and Huntail. Breloom. We have Ninjask and Blaziken. I have Breloom with rock type moves. I also have Azumarill for Blaziken. It doesn't matter how fast he gets with speed boost, I can still Aqua Jet it. If we weren't doing teams at 3, I would bring Azumarill with a choice ban. But the ability of my opponent just to switch in one of the numerous other water type Pokemon is annoying. Opposing Breloom. I have my own Breloom to avoid Spore. I also have Alakazam, which can take a hit. And I can burn it as well. And then I can also hit it with a Nice Shard. Alakazam. These two Pokemon have Ghost moves. Alakazam struggles to touch Sableye unless it's carrying Dazzling Gleam. And even then I can get off a free Dark Pulse and then hit it with a priority move. Dragons are taken care of. If I happen to encounter another Soldew, Latios, I'd probably have to send in my own to counter it and risk the speed tie. I can also use the Sash on Alakazam. Then those faster threats, I Shard for both of those two. And then I also have Mach Punch, so it doesn't really matter that you're that fast. Trick Room might be annoying with this team, but fortunately Sableye and Azumarill function really well in Trick Room. And I also have priority on those two, so even if a Trick Room does go up, it doesn't necessarily matter. Let's see. I got those guys covered. I got possible steel types there. Mega Metagross, Shadow Ball. Because he's not faster than either of these two with his Bullet Punch. I can also Mach Punch him to put him in range of the Shadow Balls. I can punch him to put him in range of my balls. Okay, yeah, that's a phrase. I know you guys wanted me to say that, so I just went ahead and got it out of the way. I can Earthquake him. I won't outspeed, so he'll probably just Meteor Mash me. That would suck. I don't think a Bullet Punch from him kills. I can check really fast. Oops, that is not what I meant to type. Darn it. Let's try this one more time. Metagross. There we go. Mega Metagross. The physical attacking set versus my Mega Glalie. And yeah, I might have 4 in HP, I guess. I don't know. If they're using a Metagross, it would probably be Adamant for the worst case scenario. And we're talking bullets. We're talking punches. We're talking getting hit by a bullet that's been punched at you at a very high speed. If I could find the move. Alright, here we go. Bullet Punch. Max attack. Da da da. Good, good. That better not be a 1-hit KO. Okay, good. It's a 2-hit KO. Wow, that does a lot of damage. Jeez. That's too bad. I really wanted to use Cacturne. So Glalie, Sableye. Sableye has that nice utility of not needing a Mega Ball but either, so I can use Glalie and Sableye and still get a lot of utility out of him. Azumarill, Breloom, Alakazam, and Latios. I don't have any fire type moves, which I would really like. Do I have any room here to bring in? I don't have Hidden Power Fire. Blaziken is really the only fire type Pokemon I can get access to reliably. But I don't want to use Blaziken anyway. I don't like Blaziken. I do like these guys. All the Pokemon here I actually like to an extent. Cacturne would just be so nice. That's killing me. I could take out. I don't like having two psychic types. That is weird. But if I take out one of them for Cacturne, then I'll have two grass types. Granted, I think I'm much more likely to face Sucker Punch and flying type moves than I am to face water type moves being stand. But just water type immunity is so nice with water absorb. Granted, I also don't really have anything super defensive besides Sableye. This is a pretty offensive tree, 6 Pokemon here. You know, I like this. We're going to stick with this, and we're just going to see how things go. So we have Mega Glalie, max speed, because he gets base 100 speed after he Mega Evolves, going Earthquake, Ice Shard, Explosion, and Return. We have Mega Sableye, which can also be regular Sableye if I need the Prankster, Will-O-Wisp. We also have Recover, Calm Mind, and Dark Pulse. just so we can kind of set up on things if we get an opportunity to. Otherwise, we can hit everything. It's also a great Braylon counter. We also will have Azumarill with the Assault Vest. Running Aqua Jet, Play Rough, Facade, and Knockoff, just in case I get burned. I can handle some of those threats very nicely. Then we also will be using Breloom with Lumberry, Spore, Bullet Seed, Mach Punch, Rock Tomb. Pretty nice there. If Salamence tries to set up on me instead of just knocking me right out, I can also Rock Tomb him, which is pretty cool. Or I could put him to sleep, which is even cooler. Sash Alakazam for a little bit of insurance. Just running Taunt, Shadow Ball, Dazzling Gleam, and Psychic. And then Soldew Latios for the Memento, which is fun to use after, because you can take a couple more hits as a Latios. And then if you get to the low HP, you can just use Memento to bring in any of these guys a little bit more easily. Madrico Meteor and Psyshock will probably be the two main attacks I'm using, with Shadow Ball there just for stuff like Mega Metagross. So that will be the team, and we'll see how it goes. So I hope you guys enjoyed this team building tutorial. Ran a little bit long, but that is how we roll sometimes. I wanted to make sure I do a really thorough one. If nothing else, you can watch it while you're playing your own battles. So there will be a battle video up on Saturday showing how I'm doing in the tournament. Hopefully I can get some live narrated ones done as well. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will talk to you all later. Bye bye now.